Hey everyone, it's Sarah and welcome back to this pregnancy vlog. So in this vlog, I'm going to talk about heartburn and pregnancy. So what is causing heartburn during pregnancy and when does it happen? Well, whenever you're pregnant, there's so many changes going on in your body. And one change is that your uterus is expanding and growing because your baby is growing. Now, as that happens, everything moves up. So as the uterus moves up, that's gonna put more pressure on your stomach, which has acid in it. And that's gonna cause it to backflow into your esophagus and cause that pain that you have. Plus, those lovely hormones that you have during pregnancy like to relax things. And one of the things that relaxes are those sphincters that normally keep that stomach closed so that acid can't backflow into the esophagus. So that can lead to your heartburn. And heartburn really varies whenever it occurs for a woman during her pregnancy. Some women can have it early on, some women have it later on. For me, it has really varied. Like I had it at the beginning, and I talked about that in some of my other videos, but it got really intense for me during that second to third trimester. And whenever you're having heartburn, for me, what my symptoms feel like is that it feels like if I was going to have a heart attack, like that is what it would feel like. Like I get this intense pain in my chest, and it literally feels like it's my heart. Hence, I guess that's why they call it heartburn. And if it gets worse, it progresses and it actually radiates to my back, and it's just very, very uncomfortable. So I've noticed that my heartburn really runs in like episodes, and it's usually triggered by something that I have done, especially whenever I start hitting those late times in pregnancy. So I noticed that if I've ate like a fatty, greasy meal and I lay down really close to the time I ate that meal, I start to get heartburn. Or if I've just really been consuming a lot of things that are sort of outside my diet, like I've indulged myself in my cravings. A couple weeks ago, I actually got Captain D's and it triggered another episode of heartburn. And then what happens is that I get heartburn and it'll start that night and it'll literally start lasting for like 2 to 3 days unless I do certain remedies to help decrease it, and then it'll go away. And as long as I eat a certain diet, I'm okay. Now let me share with you some things that I have done to help me manage my heartburn. So one of the things that people do and I've done is take antacids. Now, before you take antacids, you want to make sure it's okay with your OB provider, because these antacids can actually interfere with other medications you may be taking. Plus, before you take them, read the instructions, because they say that pregnant women should only take 5 tablets within 24 hours. So you don't want to just keep popping these like candy. They don't taste too bad, but you wouldn't want to do that, because a really bad side effect of these is that it increases your risk of constipation, and you don't want to have constipation during pregnancy. You're already uncomfortable, so why add that onto it? Now, the antacids, they help me. It seems like I got better results with them during my first pregnancy compared to this pregnancy. So I have found that I take the prescribed amount of antacids, but sometimes it just really doesn't work. So I have to do some other things to help, especially whenever I get in those cases where I start having the long episodes of heartburn, where I literally wake up in the morning with heartburn and go to bed with heartburn. So one of my go-to foods is a banana. And I like the banana really ripe. This could probably go a little bit longer, but I chew it up and I get it like liquidy in my mouth, and then I swallow it and let it go down there and coat my esophagus and down in my stomach. And it works really well. Bananas are alkaline, so whenever it goes in there, it's gonna help combat that acid that you have going on in your stomach. Another food I like to go to are apples, and apples are great. I do the same thing. Always make sure you chew it up really good before you swallow it, because that's going to help coat that area down in your stomach. It helps as well. I also like to use like just white rice or just plain oatmeal. I have also found that bread, like I eat gluten-free bread. It doesn't have dairy or wheat in it. And if I just have plain bread, that helps as well. Plus, another thing I have found that helps is rice milk. You can find it in the stores. I think Rice Stream makes it, and that helps. Now, I say that I use all these foods. I just don't go and have like 5 bananas and 5 apples and a big glass of rice milk. I use it over several hours because you just don't want to dump a lot of food in your stomach because that's going to increase the pressure in your stomach and cause more acid reflux. And sometimes whenever I'm really desperate and I'm not really sure what's working or not, I do take maybe a couple tablespoons of just vinegar and it seems to help. I'm not for sure if it helps 100% because I've done everything else, but I have noticed when I do all those things over a long period of time that the heartburn does go away and it stays away for a while. Now let's talk about some things that I definitely avoid during pregnancy that I don't eat because I know it's going to trigger heartburn. Like I can eat these foods normally whenever I'm not pregnant and be fine, but whenever I'm pregnant, I cannot eat them. So some things that cause heartburn in me and in a lot of people are like fried greasy foods. And this could be, you know, anything you get from fast food, but it can also be meats like hamburger meats or really fatty steaks can trigger it. Also, spicy foods can as well. I had tacos a couple weeks ago and literally that night it started causing heartburn. And it was just like a little bit of chili powder and onion powder and garlic powder that I added to it, but it really triggered me. So you want to avoid, you know, those things as well. Plus soft drinks. I thought, oh, I'm going to try this soft drink. Like I had an episode of heartburn and I had a 7-Up and literally after an hour of drinking that 7-Up, the heartburn came back with a vengeance and it was really bad. Plus any dairy products. I normally don't really eat dairy anyways because I'm a little intolerant to them, but that can trigger heartburn in some people. Plus a lot of sweets can. I remember during Easter, I had made us a cake and I ate a lot of the cake because it was really good, but it led to my heartburn. So you probably want to limit a lot of sugar consumption as well. Okay, so that is how I deal with my heartburn, what causes it, and I hope some of those remedies help you get some relief because I'm telling you, I know how bad this is. It literally feels like you're having a heart attack. So, you know, if you have suffered from this in your pregnancy or you know someone who has, please share with the viewers and with me some things that you have done. And also be sure to check out my other videos in this vlog series.